I want to know your honest opinion. I really don't want your honest opinion, because if you give it to me, it's going to hurt my feelings. Hello everyone, itsmontez.com. Thanks so much for tuning in. Today I'd actually like to talk to you a little bit about constructive criticism and how you take it. So I've spoken to a lot of people via Twitter or YouTube speaking about, you know, some of the instances that they have in their videos or some of the content that they have, or I've even spoken to people face to face. They'll ask me, you know, like, what do you think of my song? And I'll give them my opinion. A lot of the times when I give my opinion, I give it off straight, you know, like straight to the point. Like, there's no sense in me telling you what you want to hear. You know, I want to give you the truth of how I feel. So I'll give the feedback and the person gets mad at me. And they'll unfriend me on Facebook. They'll unfollow me on Twitter. They'll start putting bad comments on my page and stuff like that. Here's my thing. Is, like, if you're going to ask someone's opinion on what they think about your content and they shoot it down and they don't like it, well, here's the first thing. It's not for everybody. Your content may not be for everybody, you know, like, and that one person's opinion isn't everyone's opinion, you know. Now, whenever that person gives you their feedback and maybe they're telling you a different way to go about it, you can either A, listen to it, or B, not listen to it, you know, like, but if you take this material to a professional, let's say you take it to, like, you got an album and you're a rapper and you want to take it to Dr. Dre and Dr. Dre tells you the album sucks. Like, are you going to be mad at Dr. Dre because he told you it sucks? You know, that's what I'm trying to get to right there is whenever you get the feedback, don't be mad about the feedback. Take it and use it and utilize it the best way you can.